Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Christine George and welcome to Treat the Pain. Today's episode, we're going to be working on kids and the heavy backpacks they've been wearing. We're going to talk about the way they wear it and how they should wear it and what exercises we can do so they can help protect their spine long term. Whenever you're ready, let's get to it. Hello everyone. So today we have Lydia and she's gonna show you first how she's been wearing her school bag, and then we're gonna talk about how she should be wearing her school bag. So right now she's wearing it on one shoulder, it's heavy, her hands are bent, her knees are bent. That's putting a lot of improper weight on the body, and with time that could hurt her spine. Now how she should be doing it, Lydia, go ahead and put that other hand in for me. There we go, thank you, my dear. Both straps should be on the shoulder. I wish I had brought a nicer bag, but a bigger strap is even better. A more surface area, the better. Now, if you turn around, you'll see that this is really low on her back. Again, that's not how we should be wearing a school bag. It should be lifted higher, and it should be like so. It should be curving and supporting her back. Make sure your child does not have their school bag on one shoulder. Make sure there's a proper amount of weight. The way we do it is anything past 10 pounds is too much. So if she's holding that much weight in her bag, she should either get another bag or get two bags and hold them in her hand. Now, let's talk about the exercises that she can do to help prevent any damage to her spine. Let's go ahead and take that bag off you, my dear. Thank you. So, the first one's a lot of fun. It's a side plank. You ready for me? Let's do it. So on your side you go. Go ahead. Yep. Go ahead. Now lift. So she's nice and neutral. She's on her hand. Her core is engaged. Her knees are tight. She's holding that position. I like to have patients hold this position for a few seconds and then slowly release. Good job. Do the other side so you're even. Always have them do both sides. Do it this way. And then there we go. Excellent. Ready? Good job. Again, nice neutral position. She's engaging her core. Her knees are stable. She's holding it really well. Good. Relax, my dear. So that's really good for the sides. Next, we're gonna have you do Brugger's. We did those in a previous episode, but this is great for the mid back. Ready? So go ahead and face the front. You can sit down on your knees or on the chair, it's fine. Thumbs up, tuck your chin in, tuck, tuck, tuck. You're gonna give yourself a double chin. It's gonna feel really weird. That's how I want you to do it. Now slowly engage them back. You should feel it right back here. That's a really good way to strengthen your back. These are known as Brugger's. We use them for rounded shoulders, and we could also use them for a heavy bag. And then slowly release. For young ones and for ones who are growing, I tend to recommend like 3 sets of 10. But again, that depends on the patient, depends on their history, depends on the case, and depends on how much they can tolerate. Be very gentle. Next, make sure you drink a lot of water. If you feel any pain or discomfort, always tell mom or dad. And don't sit around with a lot of pain in your spine, because you have to be cautious of your body, okay? And Lydia, thank you so much for helping me today. Welcome back everyone. So I had Lydia explain or go over the different exercises that we can do for the mid back to protect us from a heavy bag. So the exercise is really focused on the mid back or the thoracic spine, this area right here. The exercise given, especially Brugger's once again, is great for keeping our posture nice and straight. We also worked on the side planks. So the side planks help engage our core. When you have a nice strong core, you can actually prevent back pain, low back, and so much more. So these are great exercises to give to the little kiddos during PE class or to do at home as a family. They'll really help with that pain. Now, be conscientious of your child. Make sure their bags are always worn correctly. Make sure they're not slouching. If they're complaining of pain or if you notice a change in how they walk, be aware of that. These are all signs of different conditions to the back that parents should notice. If you feel like they're tired or fatigued, also be aware of that and make sure we know what's the cause of that. Finally, always talk to a healthcare professional about your child's pain or their discomfort, because that's how you'll know how to protect your baby. Thank you, and I hope you had a good day.